Today, inshallah, junior 6, we're going to discuss together dangers of electricity and how to deal with it. Anything in our life, when we use it in good way, we can get benefits from it. When we use it in wrong way or without any precautions, we will get some dangers of it, not benefits, okay? Electricity the same. So number one, what are the benefits from electricity? Electricity is important, yes, very important. We can't live without electricity. Why? Because we use electricity in cooking food, like microwave. When we use microwaves that work by electricity to cook the food, so we use electricity to cook the food and preserve or keep it cold. How? We use electricity to preserve it cold. When we put the food inside the refrigerator, refrigerator is a machine worked by electricity, right? So without electricity, we can't keep our food cold or preserve it cold. Yes, so we use electricity in cooking food and preserving it cold. Number two, in lighting. Lighting what? Our houses, factories, streets, and so on. Number three, operate some machines. We use electricity in operating some machines like radio, television, washing machine, electric iron, electric heater, and so on for machines that work by electricity. Now, before talking about dangers of electricity, let's differentiate between electric conductors and electric insulators. Number one, electric conductors. From previous, we said that electric conductors are materials that allow the flow of electric current through them. Electric conductors, like iron, for example, allow electricity or the electric current to flow or move through them. A copper is a material that allows the electric current to pass or flow through them. And also iron, aluminium, and water, and also the human body. The human body is from electric conductors. Yes, human body contains water, and water is considered an electric conductor. So human body is from electric conductors. Number two, electric insulators. They are materials that don't allow the electric current to pass through or flow through. So now, what is the difference between the electric conductors and the electric insulators? Electric conductors, materials allow. Electric insulators, materials don't allow electricity to pass through or to flow through. Like wood, plastic, rubber, glass, cloth, wool, and so on. Now we differentiate between them, and I have a question. When we insert a piece of copper in a closed electric circuit, but first, what are the components? Who remember me? What are the components of the electric circuit? Yes, lamp, electric wire, battery. Battery as a source of electricity. Electric current to flow through the electric wire reaches to the lamp, then the lamp light when we connect all these parts together, right? And this is called closed electric circuit. What will happen when we insert a piece of copper in this electric circuit, closed electric circuit? Yes, the lamp will light. Excellent, good reason. Because copper is from good conductors of electricity or electric conductor that allow electricity to pass through it. Another question. Instead of a piece of copper, we have a piece of plastic. When we put a piece of plastic in a closed electric circuit, the lamp will light also? No, the lamp will not light. Good reason, because plastic is an electric insulator that doesn't allow electric current to flow through it. Doesn't allow electric current to flow through it. This is about plastic. Okay? Yes. Now, we talked about benefits of electricity and the difference between electric conductors and the insulators. And now this is a time for dangers of electricity. When we deal with electricity without precautions, in wrong way, we can get some dangers. When we neglect or ignore, doesn't matter the safety precautions while dealing with electricity, what will happen? It causes dangers of electricity. So now let's talk about dangers of electricity, which is divided into direct injuries and indirect injuries. Direct injuries and indirect injuries. Direct injuries like three: fires, electric shock, electric burn. Yeah, indirect injuries, we have three types: electric fires, shock, burn. And also we have indirect injuries. Number one, electric fires. Electric fires come from where? Electric fires come from increasing the temperature of an electric machine that produces heat. Again, this is the definition of electric fire. They are fires occur as the result of increasing the temperature of an electric machine produce heat. So the word or the secret word here, increasing the temperature of an electric machine produce heat. If I ask you, write the scientific term, type of fires occur as a result of increasing the temperature of an electric machine produce heat, this is electric fire. What are the reasons for this electric fire? Number one, we place on when we put an electric machine generate heat near to or beside or close to flammable materials. Like what flammable materials? Like furniture, curtains, cloth, rugs, carpets, and so on. When we put these flammable materials close to a machine produce heat or generate heat, it will burn. In this case, we will get electric burn. We will get electric, sorry, fire. So this fire come from where? Come from putting or placing an electric machine produce heat or generate heat close to some flammable materials. Number two, plugging or connecting more than one machine in one socket. When we put or connect your mobile charger, a television, a radio, heater, and so on, all these machines, we connect them in one socket. This will cause us what? Electric overload. Overload electricity on this socket. Electric overload leads to increase the temperature of the socket and causes electric fire. Number three, not disconnecting electric current from the electric machine that generate heat after using it. Number three, not disconnecting electric current from the electric machine after using it. When you have a shower, for example, and you leave the bathroom without disconnecting the heater, what happened? It still work and work and work, and its temperature will increase, causing electric fire. We have three reasons of electric fire. Number one, placing an electric machine generate heat close to flammable materials like curtain cloth, rugs, furniture, carpets, and so on. Plugging or connecting more than one machine in one socket, causing electric overload, and the wire will heats up, its temperature increase, and the increase leads to a fire, electric fire. Number three, not disconnecting electric current from electric machine generate heat, causing increasing the temperature of machine and then the electric fire. Okay, now I have a question. What is the difference between the normal fire, when the, for example, when I burn the paper with matches, this is normal fire or regular fire, and electric fire? What is the difference between them? Of course, you know that the regular fire, we can extinguish it by water without any dangers. But in case of electric fires, we can't use water. Give reason. This is a very important question. Give reason. We can't use water to extinguish the electric fires, this type of fires, because water is a good conductor of electricity that increase the fire and may harm the rest person. Okay, but we will use what? We will use the sand, of course. Number two, electric shock. Electric shock, okay, but first, electric shock is what? Is from the direct injuries from dangers of electricity. Yes, the second, the type of direct injuries from the dangers of electricity. Resulted from where? From passing the electric current through the human body. Secret word here is human body. Passing through the human body. If I ask the right scientific term, what of dangers of electricity resulted from passing electric current through the human body? It will be electric shock. Okay? But how the electric current pass through the human body? When your body becomes a part of a closed electric circuit. Okay, how? Number one, if a part of your body touches a non-insulated wire that has electric current inside it. Again, when a part of your body touch a non-insulated wire has an electric current inside it. And another part of your body touch the ground. You understand? Your body divided into two parts. One of them touch a non-insulated wire contain electric current. And the second part of your body touch the ground. By this way, you will make a complete or a closed electric circuit. You will make a closed electric circuit. And your body will be a part of this closed electric circuit. Like the piece of copper, if you remember, like the piece of copper, your body is a good conductor of electricity that allows the electric current to flow through from the first part of the wire to the second part of the wire. So you will get by this way electric shock. You will get electric shock as a result of passing the electric current through your body. Or when the other part of your body touch an electric conductor that connected to the ground also. Okay? And number two, if your body, part of your body, touch two wires conducting electricity. Two wires conducting electricity. When you touch, for example, by the left hand, an electric wire has electric current, and the second hand you also touch an electric wire has electric current. When you touch two wires connecting to electricity, also your body becomes a part of electric circuit, closed electric circuit, and your body allow the flow of electricity through it, so you will get electric shock. You will get electric shock. So again, electric shock comes from where? Electric shock resulted from passing electric current through the human body. Okay? Harms resulting from electric shock depends on. Number one, the strength of the electric current. The electric current may be strong, very strong, or may be weak. So the harms of electric shock depends on the strength of the electric current pass through the human body. And number two, time taken by the electric current to pass through this human body. May the electric current pass through the body for 1 second, 3 seconds, 10 seconds, 1 minute. So the harms here depend on the duration, the time taken by passing the electric current through the human body. And remember, Junior 6, that electric shock may be cause this. Again, electric shock may cause death. So, at final, electric shock happen if your body or if anybody become a part of a closed electric circuit. The reason? Because the human body allow electric current to flow through it. And now, let's talk about the electric burns. Electric burns also related to the human body. But in this case, electric burns resulting from dangers of electricity that causes damage of the body tissue. Again, electric burns, they are burns resulting from electricity that causes damage of the body tissue. Let's make it more simple. Reasons for electric burn. Okay, when your body touches, number one, fire or spark resulted from the electric fire. When I have an electric fire, this fire produces flame or spark, and your body touch it. And your body touch this spark or this fire, you will get electric burn. Yes, excellent. When a part of your body touch a machine that generates heat, you will get also electric burn. So this electric burn comes from where? From touching part of your body to an electric machine generate heat, or touch a fire or a spark resulted from the electric fire. Or when your body touch a source of electric current directly. For example, when you insert any metallic object inside the socket, electric socket. By this way, you directly touch the source of electricity and you will get electric burn. So again, reasons of electric burn: when you touch fire or spark resulted from electric fire, electric machine generate heat, when you touch it, you will get electric burn. You will get damage of your body tissue. Okay, when you get electric shock, okay, when you touch directly a source of electric current, you will get electric burn. So again, electric burn, they are burns that resulting from electricity that causes damage in the body tissue. Again, electric burn come from where? Come from electricity causes damage of your body tissue. When you touch a fire or a spark of electric fire, touch a machine generate heat, touch directly a source of electric currents, all these reasons causes electric burn. Number two, electric or indirect injuries of dangers of electricity. This caused the boy falling from a top of a ladder due to an electric shock. So when you fix, for example, a lamp, and you are on a ladder, the top of the ladder, and you get electric shock by touching the wire of the lamp that has electricity in it, you will get electric shock. What will happen? Your body will be backward and you will fall down from the ladder. So this is injuries from electricity, but indirect. Okay, but what happened when I have a person suffer from injuries of electricity? First of all, insulate the injured from electric current. Number one, we must disconnect the electricity, or pushing this man, pushing him with a material. This material is a bad conductor of electricity, like wood, plastic. To prevent the transferring of electricity from the injured person to our body. Again, number one, disconnect the electricity, or if you can't disconnect the electric current, you must push the injured with a material bad conductor of electricity like wood or plastic. Why? To prevent transferring of electricity from the injured person to your body. Also, you must open the tight closes of the injured. to facilitate breathing. And then between the heartbeats of the injured by pressing on his chest, start artificial respiration immediately if the injured can't breathe. The last part here, precautions in dealing with electricity. Number one, don't place several connections or connections in the same socket. Don't plug or connect more than one machine in one socket. Remember, I will not say a new point here. What we will see now, we said it before. How? All the reasons for the direct injuries, we will put not or don't. How? Let's see. Number one, when we said electric fire caused by connecting more than one machine in one socket. This is the reason. Connecting more than one machine in one socket, this is the reason for the electric fire. Precautions, put don't. Don't place several connections or more than one machine in one socket. Number two, don't insert a metal object in the socket to prevent your body from the electric shock. Don't touch the electric machine that has electric current with wet hand to prevent your body from electric shock. Don't leave an electric machine, if you remember, that are connected to the electric current while taking a bath. Don't play with electric connections. This is so harmful, specific on children. Don't fix or clean any electric machine while connected with electric current without disconnecting it again. Don't try to fix or touch or clean any electric machine connected to electric current without disconnecting it. Don't place or put flammable materials near to the electric machines that produce heat. Number eight, don't leave wires naked. The naked here equal non-insulated. Non-insulated. Because if you touch a non-insulated wire has electric current, you will get electric shock and also electric burn. Don't extend the electric wires. Don't put the electric wires on the ground. Why? If you do that, if you put the electric wires on the ground, you will trip on them while walking. You will trip and fall down on the ground while walking. Place a piece of plastic on the socket. Place a piece of plastic on the socket. Why? To prevent the reaching of the children to the electric source or this socket. And to prevent inserting another body in it, of course, by the children. Thank you, Junior 6.